What's going on, everybody? Had a bunch of people ask me how to polish these big boxes without leaving that seam in the middle. So I'm actually gonna show you guys here. I like to start going to the right because this box is completely unpolished and it's just a raw finish box. I used a little bit of hand polish. Our solvent in our hand polish actually cleans up all the sticker adhesive. So I cleaned up all that sticker adhesive, but this section is so long, I'm gonna have to break it up into one spot. And then when I get to my second pass with my first cut of color, I'm gonna go end to end with it. But for right now, I'm gonna break this up into two sections. Now, why would I break this up into two sections? Because if I go from end to end without using a really wet rouge, I'm gonna dry out my compound by the time I get to the other side. So I'm gonna do half and half to start getting a little bit of, if you've watched some of my other videos, you've heard me talk about putting moisture into the aluminum. I would put some moisture into this side and then I'll come back and I'm actually gonna lean it in two directions. So when I start at this right side here and go to the left, I'm actually gonna lean my buff at a 45 to the left. And then when I get to the far end here, I'm gonna turn back and cut it a second time, 45 the opposite direction. So not a full cross cut, but like a quarter cross cut both ways. So once I do that, then I'm gonna go to my white. I'm gonna use a white stitch wheel with a secondary bar to go end to end, because now that I've got it really covered really well, I can come through with a white wheel and blend everything together. And then once I go with that, I'm gonna finish it out with a really fine white wheel. So if you guys can see this box here, I've already got the cut both directions done on that. But I'll throw my respirator on and I'm gonna do this cut here. I'm gonna slide you guys over a little bit so you guys can see. I'm gonna bring you over to the other side here so you can see this cut, and then you'll see, I'll move you back. So bear with me here. So here you can see little hashy and got some lines in it right now. That's just our first primary cut to get some on it. If you look over here, this is a lot clearer. A lot clearer than over here. Now, I'm gonna turn this around and go back the opposite direction. As you saw, I was on a 45 that direction. Now I'm gonna come back a 45 the other way. Alright, now that I got it all blended together, the two pieces, now I'm going to switch on to my white wheel and put it all together. Now what I'm going to do is I'll go full end to end with this one. All right, so now that I got the stitch buff out of the way, and the reason I use that on these big flat ones is because they're so thin, I don't want to overheat them. If I overheat them, they're going to start warping and popping at me, and I don't want to do that. I want to keep it as square on as I can. And I'm going to try to bring you guys over this way so you can start seeing the finished product. I'm going to clean the lens off here. There we go. Now let me see if I can get this to stay over here where you can actually see what it's doing. Come on, stay there. Nope. Stay there. Well, I'm going to try it anyways. Maybe it'll stay there. Simple. Like I said, when I was down here, I'm more comfortable going 45 to the left because I hold the grinder by the body, and I want to make sure that that first cut is as tight and as close together and perfect pressure as I can get. And then my second pass, I'm less comfortable going to the right, so then I go to the right at that 45, the opposite direction. But all I'm doing is cleaning up some of the excess compound and getting more cut on it. And then my next one, I go perfectly vertical with a white sewn wheel with some green, and when I do that, I turn it down to about 2200 on a 10-inch, and I go 2200 straight up so I can start blending it all together, and then I finish it up with an untreated white on these because they're so thin. If I were to use the 40 plies, the 40 ply would leave it really super hashy because it's really light and it would take a bunch of rouge. I don't want to do all that. But for those of you that were wondering how I do that, now there's no line here in the middle where I overlapped it. I made sure my 45s were to the right and to the left. If I had kept my buff on my cut straight up vertical, I'd have a perfect line in the middle where I overlapped. But since I pulled all that excess compound with me going to the right and to the left, I took all that with me. Now I don't have a line in the middle. And then when I did my first and secondary color, that cleaned all that up. So thank you guys for tuning in. I appreciate you guys watching all these videos, but this is how to polish a big flat box. this one was brand new, and now we're out to a nice mirror. So catch you guys later.